Meet Swampletics, my Mauritania-locked ultimate Ironman. Since December of 2018, I've been living strictly in Mauritania. I'm an ultimate Ironman account, which means I can't use banks and I can't trade other players. This is my story. I'm going to be taking on one of RuneScape's biggest challenges, the Theater of Blood. It's over, Verzik. You're outmatched. I've trained for months within the confines of Mauritania for this very moment. Against all odds.
Oh, Swampletics.
That's your voice?
What are you trying to say here?
Nothing. I expected it to be more feminine or something.
Are you calling me ugly?
No, of course. No.
Oh.
Okay, listen, I'm not here to play games.
You think the gear obtained in this region is enough to get through to me? This isn't a comedy club, little boy.
I never have any food at Verzik, because she always eats it all. Yeah, because she loves food.
Did that pass a poll, or...
A what now?
You know what? It doesn't matter. Your time is up.
Oh, is it? That's a bold statement coming from a guy with an empty glove slot.
That's impossible. I could have sworn I...
What kind of adventurer doesn't take advantage of his glove slot? You're mine, Swampletics.
No! Achieve 99 Hunter, I need to catch 85,674 swamp lizards. The Theater of Blood is rapidly approaching. I've slowly checked item after item off this list, and we've come down to the final melee item I need. Filling the glove slot. This is a bigger deal than you think. Welcome to the three chapters of obtaining a combat bracelet in Mauritania. My team of four players who will take on the Theater of Blood with me have to match my exact gear and inventory. And they also have to comply with my own unlocks in the region. If I don't have a combat bracelet, they don't have a combat bracelet. It's my single biggest offensive upgrade that isn't the weapon slot, and it helps me with all my future goals. The thousands of gargoyles taking revenge on the vampires, and ultimately, the theater. In a way, however, this is less about unlocking one combat bracelet and more about unlocking four of them, for my entire team. Implings, quite literally, change everything. And to unlock them all, I'll need to stay in these 16 Tiles of Solitude for approximately 200 hours. There's several milestones on our way to the ultimate 99 Hunter where we unlock Lucky Implings, and today, we focus on 93. Along the road to 93 Hunter, we need to catch 47,261 Swamp Lizards, being a little over half of what I need for 99. With Dragon Implings come Dragon Stones, a 1 in 19 chance in comparison to camping the rare drop table for one, which could take hundreds of hours. A wholesome start to chapter 1 as we fill our very cramped inventory with nets and ropes. I'm definitely gonna have to make some space here. This is not an ideal situation, but we'll figure it out.
39!
This is gonna be a satisfying level 40 Hunter, which means I can now hunt with three traps here. My XP is about to skyrocket. It is actually, I think I could probably get like 45k an hour right now with three traps. Let's set our first checkpoint at 60 Hunter. There's a ton of unlocks at 60 Hunter, and that should take maybe 6-7 hours tops, so let's go get some levels. 41. 45 Hunter. And there's 48. And the big 50. Oh my god, guys, we're halfway there. 52. 54. And there's 58. And after hunting pretty much all day, probably about 6 or 7 hours for this level, 60 Hunter. There we go. Oh, that looks so clean, man. So clean. 4 traps now. 1,500 total on this account. That is something, man. That is something. Not gonna lie to you guys, my inventory is giving me anxiety, especially now that I'm going to be consistently placing 4 traps, so I'm gonna clear some space, you know, just... I'd feel bad dropping the ores and bars, so these should take like 15 minutes to use up and then we'll be free. Won't have to carry them around for the next 13 million experience. 1k until 51 smithing. Gains. Sixty-five, Hunter, baby. 10 more until magpies, that's hype. Oh my god, guys, he's back. On a more important note, look at that boot on the ground. Isn't that freaking cool? Old Boot is my favorite reoccurring Swampletics character. 67! Well, after a total of about 30 hours of hunting so far, there is 75 Hunter, and we have officially unlocked the entirety of the Magpie Impling Droptail, which for some reason it just doesn't show barehanded Impling messages, but I guess that would be kind of redundant, but we do have access to that entire drop table now. Magpie Implings are basically the money Impling. Compared to a lot of the other Implings, it's decent, but for the most part, it offers us a shield upgrade, which is the Rune Square Shield, and we'll be going for that when we're catching them. Ah, I haven't seen one in so long, man. All the genies now are going on to Herblore, so we can put a dent in that grind towards 55. As you can tell, I've been pretty consistently depleting my run energy all the way to 0, and it's hurting my XP rates, so here's what we're gonna do about it. Since I unlocked magpies, I won't be needing this anymore, so this frees up 6 kilograms. One nasty little thing that I've just now figured out is I currently weigh 71 kilograms, which is ridiculous. Your run energy depletes in like 0.2 milliseconds. But if we drop all these lizards, then 35. So I'm just gonna have to start dropping them as I go, otherwise this is not gonna be fun for me. 77, Hunter.
78.
So close to the big 80, man. 79, Hunter. I'll see you guys in a couple hours. And there she is, 80 Hunter, solely off Swamp Lizards. We can now place 5 traps at a time. I've been doing some thinking while approaching this level, and realistically, this place was just not made for 5 traps. I could place one right here, but it's just not efficient from everything I can tell. I already run out of run energy. I always have a trap to pick up. It's not like I have any downtime. We're just gonna go full steam ahead towards 93 right now, 4 traps at a time, and we're hovering around the 60,000 experience mark when well focused, so it's not too bad at the moment. The infamous 83 for Dragon Implings. A net is what separates us from reality, unfortunately. I'll see you in 5 hours for 84. Just got the big 84, another Impling checkpoint, and also a pretty damn big one. With 84, we've just added Ninja Implings to our arsenal. We just unlocked Rune Knives and Darts for range training, and most importantly, Easy Prayer Potions. They actually drop 4 noted prayer potions, and that's insanely convenient for Barrow's runs, which I'm still gonna do, by the way. 60 hours deep into the grind, my friends, and we are officially 1/4 of the way to 99. Well, as Mother Teresa once said, 87 Hunter. And there's 88 Hunter. Oh, beautiful, man. Every level's taken such a long time now. Hey guys, it's me, Swamp Man. Let me tell you a story about how I've wasted about 2 to 3 hours of my time now. As you can see, I just got 20 fresh Ecto tokens. I need them to buy back my ropes. See, when you're hunting and you disconnect, your traps obviously don't stay around, so every time that happens, I gotta get more Ecto tokens, go over to buy some ropes, go get my nets back, and I've done this probably about 7 times now. And as we catch our 31,858th Swamp Lizard, 89 Hunter, we can now catch Lucky Implings with a net. 10 long levels to go, but goddamn, the thought of catching them is so exhilarating, like legitimately. I cannot wait for that moment, man. A pretty respectable 700k XP gain today. I will see you gamers in the morning. This is really funny, guys. This is really funny. 92 Hunter, we are officially halfway to 99. 42,837 Swamp Lizards caught at this point. One more level until Dragon Implings. Let's freaking get it, man.
can't hope you won't find. When you lose a fire, it gets cold. Will you make it there alone? When it's time to get older, if you can't hope you won't find.
And after 47,261 Swamp Lizards, we've made it to the second biggest hunter milestone on the account. We can now catch Dragon Implings barehanded. Whew, I started this grind exactly 2 weeks ago, which means it took 14 days to get 7.2 million hunter experience on Swamp Lizards. Dragon Stones aren't the only thing that I want from Dragon Implings. In fact, there's quite a bit that I want. They also drop Amulets of Glory, which will be my endgame amulet, so why don't we give that a try since I can catch them now. Simultaneously, I'm going to try to catch some Eclectic Implings for their 1 in 10 Oak Plank drop. You'll see what that's for later. Ah, there it is! My first Dragon Impling, man. Oh, come back! Where are you going? I have literally chased this Impling for like 2 full minutes. Oh my god! On the first one! On the first one? Are you kidding me? Oh my god. This account's a lock. I don't understand. There's no scientific reason as to why this account is so lucky. Oh my god, man. Let's unnote these. Boom. Oh, Theater of Blood amulet, baby. One entire Dragon Impling. I managed to get 8 Oak Planks in the time it took me to find that Dragon Impling. I want to try to get 8 more real quickly for some upgrades. There we go, Earth Runes, exactly what I was looking for. I can now teleport to my house. I was hunting those oak planks for this specific reason. I can now finish up my entire costume room without, God, I forgot a hammer. All right, here's the treasure chest, which is not really that great until I can actually upgrade it to teak. Armor case is up next, and there's only really one thing in here that I need. Lumberjack costume, very nice. And maybe eventually full Justiciar. Magic wardrobe, not really anything useful in here. Mystic robes, maybe. Make some tea real quick. And that is our fully fleshed out costume room. Well, chapter 2 begins a little something like this. I need 74 crafting to actually make my combat bracelet. I am currently 56, and most of that has just been from the Morton Temple, so we actually have to get crafting this time. There's 2 methods I can use. I could go back to temple trekking and camp for silver bars, although ultimately that is a lot slower than the alternative. My current best crafting method resides in good old Port Phasmatis. The method is pretty simple. Buy 10 buckets of sand and 10 soda ash here, walk over to the furnace here, make 10 molten glass, use a glass blowing pipe on the glass while walking back to the charters, sell the lantern lenses to the shop, hop worlds, rinse and repeat. It's about 25,000 experience per hour, so we can expect 74 crafting to take us approximately 40 hours to complete. So I'm just sitting here, got 60 crafting, and I remembered this video that I made like over 3 years ago now on my very first Ultimate Iron Man.
Only 2 more levels to go. This is a very miserable thing to be doing. I hate crafting.
It's so funny because I don't mind this at all now. Oh, that's so cute. Three crafting and a nice, clean, beautiful 1550 total level on the account. That is so nice. All right, 40 hours of walking simulator later. 74 crafting achieved in the region of Mauritania without the use of the banking or trading functions of RuneScape. There it is, Dragonstone bracelets. Oh, gorgeous, man, gorgeous, I love it. Well, with 74 crafting complete and a total of about 170 hours invested into this goal so far, we're on to the final chapter. Let's get some Dragonstones. Dragon Implings offer three incredibly useful drops for this account. The first obviously being Dragonstones, but equally as important in my opinion. This is how we're going to train Prayer. The higher Prayer I can get for the theater, the better. And we want as many Dragon Bones as we can possibly get our hands on. But the main focus right now is upgrading this glove slot. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got one. We have got one. Oh, that is garbage. Eclectics do drop medium clues as well, so... Ooh, funny story. Okay, funny story about these. It's not really that funny, actually. I don't know why I said that, but these are supposed to be my budget combat bracelet before, you know, actually grinding it out. But since I'm going straight for it, I guess I might as well. These aren't going to be best in slot for too long. All right, we're logging in. Fourth Dragon Impling on the account. Let's see it. No! I hate bolt tips. Impling number five has been spotted. Let's go. Did that just despawn right in? Oh my. All right, this is going to be, I think, my final impling for the day. This is going to be number eight for me. Let's see it. Glories. All right, we'll sell those. That's not too bad. Ninja impling, hard clue. Interesting. Definitely can't do that. Nope. I really need to clear my inventory. This is a mess. Oh, look at this cutie, man. Number 11. Oh, dragon arrows. Okay, here's the thing. I told myself I would keep these. I have big dreams. If I get a third age bow, I could use those arrows. We are eating well tonight, my friends. What a tease. That's my rune crossbow flying around right there. Number 16, there he is. Let's see some dragon stones. I mean, okay, it's technically... This is going to be impling number 19, so that is the drop rate for dragon stones. Let's see it. You know what? That's good. I will take, that's beautiful. It's the lowest amount of dragon bones you could get, but that's great. That is fantastic. Oh, we got a medium clue, interesting. Can this be the Mauritania clue? Is the... Wow. Okay, that is a, oh my god, that's a Mauritania clue. That's beautiful. Oh, dude, we're getting revenge soon. Dragon darts, beautiful. That's some range training right there. That is really, really nice. All right, the redemptions are up. Baby dragon bones. Look at that. That's so good. That is extremely good. That's a ton of prayer XP right there. I think 24k prayer XP in that one drop. All right, this is going to be the final dragon impling of day four. This is number 46. That's it, man. Three dragon stones. We are done. Oh my god. 46 dragon implings. Beautiful. Oh, I'm so happy. Thank you, man. Shout out this guy. Finding the dragon impling that gave us the dragon stones. All right, let's sell off everything that I don't need real quick. We're actually nearing a 1 mil cash stack once again on the account after we lost a lot of money through that temple trekking death. So we have rebuilt quite a bit of that cash stack. So here's where we run into a bit of an obstacle, my friends. You actually need 68 magic to enchant Dragonstone Jewelry. I have 67. That's a bit of a problem. It's probably going to take me several hours to get this level, and I'm going to start by doing some barrows. Oh, the rune knives are going to shred Aram. Oh my goodness. This is beautiful. Look at it. All right, hopefully we can get some good starter runes from this chest. That is pretty good. All right, let's, yeah, I can work with that. I can definitely work with that. These summer pies came in handy after all, and I get to use the prayer potions that I got from Ninja Imps. I literally only got one prayer potion drop, but it's gonna make this a lot easier. All right, there's the air staff I was looking for. Very nice. All right, final chest, if I can get some decent runes from it. Yeah, there we go. Nice, yeah. So I should just be able to use the chaos and the deaths, and that should be more than enough for 68. So we are out of here. Let's go get 68 magic, and then let's get this beautiful upgrade. And last one, 68 magic. I can now enchant Dragonstone Jewelry, which means I can now make my combat bracelet. So I do need to get a bracelet mold now, and the only way to do that is to build Tool Store 4. I only have the first one at the moment, so guess what I need to do? I need to hunt more implings, need to get more oak planks. Planks, please. Ask and you shall receive. Thanks. Let's drink some tea and then build tool store 5. There we go. We now have every single tool store in our house. Most importantly though, we have the bracelet mold. There we go. Let's take it. Whew, it's finally time. Over 200 hours of progress. All right, let's unnote the dragon stones. Oh, look at them, man. My inventory is so trashed right now, but only for a short while. All right, let's do it, man. Dragon bracelet. I nearly made all of those. Let's make one. All right, man. There it is. Dragonstone bracelet made. One final step. We now are the proud owner of a combat bracelet made entirely from scratch in Mauritania. I now have triple digit strength bonus when wearing a strength amulet and 96 when I wear the glory. So, oh, that is so freaking satisfying. I can't even tell you, man. Can't even tell you. All right, let's make the ring real quick. And this is gonna be my ring of wealth, which actually picks up coins for you and gives you better rolls on the rare drop table. So this is gonna be my best in slot ring. It doesn't actually give any bonuses, but it is a really nice convenience factor. And we get better drops on the rare drop table, so. Oh, look at that gear, man. An unmatched machine of raw power and energy right there. Now, let's get that crossbow.
So you decided to throw your life away to me after all.
I don't know about that one.
What is this? How is this possible?
That should be the least of your worries, Verzik.
Very impressive, Swampletics. But you'll need a lot more than your little bracelet to walk out of here alive.
Oh, you haven't seen anything yet.
Then show me.